गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर कीपिंग वेल। नाउ टुडे इन आर यूनिट नंबर फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस, और वी सिंपली कॉल इट डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस। ओके, आफ्टर हैविंग द नॉलेज ऑफ डायमेंशनल फॉर्मूलाज दैट यू मस्ट हैव प्रैक्टिस्ड, सो dimensional formulas we have understood. So after gaining that knowledge, now we have to see that how we can use that dimensional formulas. So there are three applications which we have to practice one by one in form of numericals. First application is to check whether the given equation is dimensionally correct. Second is to derive the relation or formula between different physical quantities. Third is to convert the unit from one system to another, like from CGS to SI. Now see students, don't worry, we will be practicing each of the application with the help of numericals. So let us start understanding the first application. How do we check that whether the given equation is dimensionally correct or not? Okay, so before starting the dimensional analysis first application, we will quickly revise these dimensional formulas which are generally used. So like distance or displacement or any kind of length, whether radius, diameter or wavelength, all are always represented by L power 1. Mass is always m power 1. Velocity is L1 t minus 1. Keep on remembering these formulas, students. Acceleration is any kind of acceleration. Any word is attached, like gravitational acceleration or centripetal acceleration. These details we'll study later. But any kind of acceleration, you have to always write for it L1 t minus 2. Okay? Any kind of force, you will always write the dimensional formula M1 L1 t minus 2. Work or energy is m1 l2 t minus 2. Power, pressure and these constants you have to remember. Now there was the detailed list of dimensional formulas, but I have given you these formulas because these are commonly used in the coming dimensional analysis. Okay, now some rules also we have to remember, that which of the physical quantities appear dimensionless. So any numerical value like pi or any fraction 3 by 2, 1 by 3, they are dimensionless. That means they don't have any unit. So they are dimensionless. So we have to remember, if pi is appearing, we don't have to put any dimension for it, okay, in our coming numericals. If any ratio is appearing of the same quantity, like angle, it is also dimensionless. Or some constants, sine theta, cos theta, log, these are also dimensionless. Okay? Now, after revising these formulas and dimensionless quantities, now we will proceed to our first example. I am starting with very simple question here. First example. Okay, so our first application is to check whether the specific formula or equation is homogeneous or dimensionally correct or not. Okay, homogeneous means dimensionally correct. Okay, so what we will be given, students, we will be given any equation like S equal to VT, any equation. Okay, and we will be asked that check whether this equation is homogeneous or not, or it can be asked dimensionally correct or not. Okay, so what you have to do, students, whatever equation is given, in that the physical quantities which are written, we will be replacing each of the quantity by their dimensional formula. Okay, and left hand side and right hand side we will solve. If the final answer is coming same, then we will write that the given equation is homogeneous. So let us start. First of all, suppose S is the quantity given. S means displacement. So left hand side is only displacement. What do we write for displacement? We write L1, that means dimensional formula L1. Okay, now right hand side is VT. So what we have to do for V and T, we have to write dimensional formula. So let us start. Velocity is L power 1 T power minus 1 written. Time means, for time we write dimensional formula T power 1. Okay, finally we will multiply the two. Now what is the rule of multiplication? T power minus 1 is also present, T power 1 is also present. So they will get cancelled. Why? Because if same basis are given, then their powers are added. So minus 1 plus 1 will become 0. And T power 0 means 1. So finally this T will go, will disappear. Only left will be L power 1. That means now we have to lastly check that the left hand side dimension and right hand side dimension, are they same? If yes, so we will write yes, this equation is homogeneous or dimensionally correct. Let's see second example. Given that the speed for the wave of a rope is v equal to root f by m, check its homogeneity using dimensional analysis. Okay, that means we have to again check it. So procedure is the same. Write this equation. So we can also write it for simplicity, v square equal to f by m. This we have written. Now left hand side and right hand side we will solve. Okay, on our left hand side we are having v square. Okay, so as I have told you, we have to replace each of the physical quantity by their dimensional formula. So what is the dimensional formula of velocity? It is L1 T minus 1, but we have to apply power 2 because on left side power 2 is also given. So L power 2 and T power it will become minus 2, because of the same base, if two powers are given, then they are multiplied. Okay, so for the same base, if two powers are given, they are multiplied. So T raised to power minus 1 and T raised to power 2. So means there are two powers. So finally it will become minus 2. So left hand side answer is this. Now let us check the right hand side answer. Right hand side we have to solve F by M. F means force. So force is m1 l1 t minus 2, and mass in the denominator it is denoted by m1. Mass ka dimensional formula kya hota hai? Capital m1. Okay, now just see that how to solve it. So similar terms will get cancelled. So you see m and m is getting cancelled. To bacha kya? L power 1 t power minus 2. Now let us check right hand side, left hand side and right hand side, are they same? Final answers, no. Yahan hai L2 T minus 2 aur yahan hai L1 T minus 2. To same nahi hai. So that's why, what do we write? We will write the answer, the above equation is not homogeneous. Okay, that means incorrect. Okay, this way we check. See third example, students. De Broglie wavelength, this you will study in chemistry. Okay, just now no worry, only formula we have to see. De Broglie wavelength, lambda equal to h upon mv is given. H means Planck's constant, m and v means mass and velocity. We have to check their dimensional consistency. See, left side lambda means wavelength, wavelength means l1 you will write. On right side, Planck's constant h, iska formula lena hai table se aur learn bhi karna hai, m1 l2 t minus 1, mass ka m1, velocity ka l1 t minus 1, ye sab substitute karne, then let us cancel and finally we are left with l1. So this is correct.